Good morning, everybody. I want to thank everybody who is here on time. And let's just take a minute or two to do some of the background logistics, and hopefully a few more of the MAG members will come in. Are we all set with the, I see the interpreters we're all set with, the transcribing and the online participation? And maybe we could, you know, this has been a really disappointing experience for those that have been trying to participate online, and I feel for their frustration. I've been in similar situations myself, and it really is extremely aggravating. And I think also there were a couple of times yesterday when I said things like sense of the room. Now, you know, I tried to say in advance that I was actually looking for whether or not there was strong support or objections for, you know, a small basket of proposals. And that certainly was as much an invitation to those that are participating online as those in the room. But our language doesn't always make that clear. So I want to make it really clear to the online participants that when I look for a sense of the room, and I'll try not to use phrases like body language, because clearly that's not visible in an online manner, I really am trying to signal and get any input from the online participants as well. So I appreciate that it's made a lot more difficult when you can't just jump in and speak to type, but even just a quick signal to Anya in the chat room that you'd like to comment and will come in means I won't close that item until we've actually heard from you online. And again, Anya, if there's anything you want to feed into the room with respect to, you know, better enabling the online participation, then, you know, please do. Just put your hand up or something. Don't worry about this queue system. So we had adopted the agenda yesterday for the 2 days, but let me just go through quickly what we want to get through today. In the first 2 hours, we'd actually like to see if we can get to the point where we're very near final for the workshop selection. Post that process, the secretariat will go away, communicate with those workshop proposers who had some conditionalities with the acceptance of their proposal. We can do some additional work in the secretariat to perhaps refine some of the, you know, potential balances or imbalances that are in, and certainly come back to the MAG with that after. But we should be to a 99% level there. Anya's just raised her hand, so let me see what she says before we go on.
I'd like to speak. Ginger, you have the floor. Madam Chair?
Ginger is saying that we're going to leave it for later. So.
I don't know if my mic is on. Well, Ginger wanted to speak, but she's saying now that we might leave it for later then.
Okay, so I think I heard you. It wasn't very clear. People need to speak closely and directly into the mic. You said that Ginger wanted to speak but would come in later? Okay, just signal me again when she's ready. So after we continue the workshop selection, and we'll come back and talk about that process this morning, we've planned a couple of hours to discuss the main sessions and some of the focus sessions. And in there, I think we'll also cover the open forums as well. And that has us concluding by sort of mid-afternoon. And then the rest of the day would be follow-up as needed based on the status updates from the open consultation for all the intersessional activities. So that's the National Regional Internet Initiatives, the Dynamic Coalitions, Connecting and Enabling the Next Billion, and the Best Practice Forums. One of the things we tried to do was not make have a lot of redundancy between the open consultation and the MAG meeting for those sort of presentations. So people should refer to the presentations that were given on 2 days ago, and if there's follow-up necessary, then we'll come to that mid-afternoon. And then the final set of activities is AOB, and I'll see if there's a call for any AOB just now. And within that, we want to work towards scheduling the third face-to-face MAG meeting, and if possible, a MAG virtual meeting schedule. So are there any other calls for AOB? Then with that, we'll move forward to the... Michael, you have the floor.
I don't have anything in this area, but it may be interesting to spend 5 or 10 minutes if there's any other issues that MAG members think should be added to the retreat agenda as a result of the 2 days that we've spent together.
Just a second here. Michael, sorry, I couldn't sort the volume out here quickly enough. Could you just quickly repeat your comment?
Yeah, I was saying that it's possible that after the 2 days we've spent together, some MAG members might have quick comments to make about topics that should be added to the retreat agenda.
Okay, we'll leave, put that under AOB. Marilyn, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Marilyn Cade speaking. I'm just reporting very quickly that perhaps under AOB, for any of the NRIs who did not get to give a quick update, on the first day when I did the overall NRI update, a couple were able to intervene. I've heard from two or three that they'd like to have 3 or 4 minutes to just mention what they've done. So if we have time under AOB, we could plan on that now, then they would be able to perhaps organize their thoughts.
Why don't we actually try and schedule that in the 4:30 to 5:15 local time slot, where we actually had some NRI time. Then with that, I'd like to propose for the morning session, I know some work was done in a smaller group, but I don't know that that's been shared with the MAG yet, and I haven't seen it either. The Secretariat did a little bit of prep work, but basically if we look at the proposals that we accepted as in the first 85, the profile of those proposals were shown yesterday, and we can pull that graphic back up. I think it's important to compare that against the profile of the entire 260 that came in. From my mind, the last 20 slots, I think, should be used to address either any imbalances we actually see in terms of the diversity characteristics we set out, returning first-time proposers versus returning developed versus developing countries. I think we should also look at the spread of thematic tags that came in the full 260 and the spread of thematic tags that we have in our first 80 and understand whether or not there are any we ought to go away and look at as an exception and pull some in. If there's a significant number of proposals that have thematic tags associated with them in the 260 that aren't pulled forward in the 85, to me that says there's some portion of the community that has an interest in this topic, and I think it behooves us to examine that and look possibly to pull those in. I think we also need a very quick discussion again on the issue of flash sessions. One of the things we wanted to do in terms of introducing some more excitement or diversity into the overall program was to have some different formats. We have the flash sessions, it's a little confusing because we're calling them the same thing, and we have the on-conference streams that Miguel and the working group have identified, and I'm not talking about those two specific activities. This is whether or not in the workshop proposals that we received, there are any sessions that were identified as flash sessions that we would want to pull in. At this point in time, I believe, and the Secretary should correct me, that we've identified one flash session in those first 85 proposals to come in. So if there were MAG members who believe that there were some flash sessions that ought to be pulled in, that's something we can get to here in the next hour or so. I'm going to come to Cheryl, who's in the queue, and then I think there's an announcement from the Secretariat as well on the floor.
Oh, yes.
So Cheryl, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I think that's a good approach to moving forward, for sure. And there, after looking through the different workshops, I had a point of clarification on yesterday and then a quick comment. Just point of clarification, is it that those 85 are definitely in? We've definitely made that decision and we're not going back to them. Just point of clarification, as some of us were talking in the room, some of us were unsure. And then I would like to comment that there is one session. It wasn't a flash session, but it dealt with the topic of healthcare and IoT. I think it might have been submitted by the government of Cuba. I have to go back and look. But I noticed that there wasn't anything else dealing with healthcare, and I think that that was a very, it's an interesting and important topic. Perhaps that could be converted to a flash session, or we could include that in some different type of a format if the proposed format is not one that the room was comfortable with. Thank you.
Thank you, Cheryl. That's a very good question. My expectation or belief on the basis of what I think we all agreed yesterday is that the proposals we identified as in, we should assume are in unless a subsequent review takes them out. The one item I didn't mention a moment ago is we had four or five areas yesterday where some MAG members said they thought there was quite a significant number of proposals that were potentially quite similar and were either candidates for merger. You know, the two that got the most time, I think, were the Internet of Things, which had six or seven, and one on quality education. The Secretariat is pulling those clumps together and is going to send a note to the MAG on the basis of those groupings that were identified yesterday. And I think we need a conversation on those. They're going to also identify which ones are already in the top 85. And those that, you know, feel quite strongly or have a specific interest in those topics, I think can then look at the six proposals on the Internet of Things, which ones are accepted, and if they have a counter proposal, bring that forward to the room. I think there was a lot of comments yesterday about the fact that there might be some redundancy, and both whether it was in the same organizations or the same topic, and we clearly don't want to do that. That doesn't make for an exciting program. So I think we need to allow some room to move some of those in and out. Chengatai also has two other announcements, which is probably going to add to our discussion here.
Yes, thank you very much, Lynn. Those four that we had put aside yesterday because they were panel sessions and didn't have a background paper, they actually all did have a background paper, just that the information did not export across when the Excel sheet was made. So there wasn't an error there at the beginning that we thought there was an error. There was no error. So we either have to revisit those or we just include them since they were in the top 60. And then the other thing is that I did a quick count and we have about 27 workshop proposals which are of 30 minutes duration. And the first one, workshop ID 142, made it in because it was in the top 85. The second one is 104th, so going down. And it did have a fairly decent grade of 3.8, the next one 3.7. So we may be able to look at those again. And some of the tags are also quite interesting. I mean, they are IGF regional, gender issues, and youth engagement is one of them. So, and those are the types we are trying to encourage. So that's for your consideration, whether or not we should just look at all the flash sessions as a whole and see which ones we want to add on. Mm-hmm.
Chengatai, one question. The 27 sessions that you just identified as 30 minutes or less were from the 85 that we selected or just in the whole 260?
They're in the whole 260. One of them, as we said, one made it in because it was in the, just one because it was 46th. And then the next one after that came 104th in the rankings.
It's actually very interesting that having wanted to get away from kind of lengthy big panel workshops and working to encourage them, that in our evaluations we found one that we thought met that criteria out of 27. I have a queue, so I'm going to go to the queue. Murad, you have the floor.
Just a logistical issue to raise with the Secretariat. Could we, could you put online the agreed top 85 proposals we agreed yesterday? And also regarding the remaining, because I remember that in the first day we said that we're going to have 110 workshop, final list of workshops. So I think that for the remaining non-selected workshops, we should also follow the already agreed principles of geographical balance, gender, etc. Thank you.
Thank you, Murad. Miguel, you have the floor.
Thanks, Chair. This is Miguel. Just to bring some clarity, we could change the name to the flash session to lightning sessions if you'd like. I think it would be better for all of us. And also, if I remember well, we had 24 slots for flash sessions, for lightning sessions now, and there are 26 lightning flash sessions that have not been selected. And that way we could offer them. Maybe not every flash session, because I don't really know how they graded, but we could offer the best ones to get into the new format. It would be actually we could give them priority.
We should probably come back and talk about that, because the flash sessions that came through the workshop proposals were of a different length, I think, than what you're planning in your and then is it a full sign-up, and so maybe we can schedule that discussion. I don't know if we'll get to it today or not, but if not, then I think it should be for our next MAG virtual call, so we can determine what we actually tell. Sure. Miguel, you have the floor.
We could not just sign them, we could offer them to adapt the format to the lightning sessions. That's what I'm saying. Thanks.
All right, no, I think that's a good comment. Marilyn, you have the floor.
Chair, thank you. I'm certainly open to following the chair's proposal for how we proceed, but I ask that we have a document to work from. We all know what document we're working from. And so I support your comments, but I also think that if we're not quite there yet in terms of time, and the Secretariat needs to have a little more time to organize, such as into clusters or whatever, then perhaps you could switch the discussion of the main sessions in terms of order, and the Secretariat, who are focused on this additional work, could be allowed to do that. Because I'm just going to say, I have two devices in front of me. Not everybody does. I'm semi-English speaking, since I'm from Missouri. mostly we speak hillbilly there. but I am struggling with our going back and forth. So, please.
Yes, I think some additional processing would certainly have been helpful for the discussion here, and I'm trying to get a sense of the process we want to run and what's available to us. Chengatai is asking for the floor, and then I'll go back.
No?
Oh, okay, well then, Cheryl, you have the floor.
Thank you. I just want to park something for later. We don't have to discuss it now, but I really hope that we, after we go through this whole process, have in place an idea for how we're going to proceed in terms of giving feedback to those that did not make it through, particularly folks who were new proposers or from groups that we're trying to encourage to submit proposals, because I think after going through this, if I had submitted a proposal and looked online and read the transcript, I would think, oh my goodness. And we don't want to discourage people from not coming back next year and making an even stronger proposal. So I really think that we need to focus on that if we have some time later today. I don't know if it's a conference call, but some real form of outreach where we can actually give actual real constructive feedback, not just a letter saying, sorry, you didn't make it. Thank you.
And I think that's a good comment, Cheryl. And I know the Secretary does have a process. Chengatai, do you want to comment to that?
Sorry, can you just repeat the question? I was conferring about something else. So.
Basically, I think Cheryl was asking what is the process to get back to those candidates that were not selected, and her concern was that they make sure that they understand, that feel comfortable with the process and aren't discouraged from participating in the future.
Oh, basically. No, definitely. We do send emails out to everybody, those that were accepted with no comment, those were conditionally accepted, and those that were not accepted. We also, last year, what we did was that we also sent out the comments that the MAG members made. I mean, we did some a little bit of editing, but so that for the next time they know what their deficiencies were if the MAG members did make some constructive comments to the workshops. Yes.
Juan, you have the floor, and then I will come back and comment on Marilyn's last comment or proposal.
Thank you, Chair. I only want to ask a question and have a comment. The question is, how are we going to proceed now? Do we have to complete the list to select 25, more or less, workshop on top of the one that we selected yesterday? That's what we have to do? And if the answer is yes, because I see the chairwoman nodding, I think that that's very important, because this is the opportunity in which the MAG will exercise its criteria to balance the program of the IGF, that in the end is the main task of the MAG. In this sense, I underline what my colleague just said, that we have to have some criteria for the selection of this extra 25 workshop. One of the criteria undoubtedly is the regional balance of the workshops, and in that sense that can be done in two ways. One way is the proposal of the workshop nationality, but also is the nationality of the speakers in all workshops. So that can be a two way of doing it. For your information, I checked on the 85 selected workshop that we did yesterday, and from Latin America and Caribbean region, we have 15. That is not so bad. Maybe we should have a little bit more, because it's the region in which the IGF is going to be held, but 15 is not so bad. It's distributed by 7 from Brazil, 4 from Argentina, and 1 each from Mexico, Colombia, and Trinidad and Tobago. So having said that, I will put to the MAG consideration what I said yesterday, that another criteria for the selection of these remaining workshops should be the topic, because as it was mentioned yesterday, there's a few topics that are repeated extensively in the already selected 85. And on the other hand, there are some very important topics that are not considered at all, and especially those topics that are directly related with the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, that, you know, this year we are trying to align this IGF with the Sustainable Development Goals. So I think that we should open, I have it open in my computer, the Sustainable Development Goal, the 17, and that should be, I think, a hourglass to check the remaining workshops. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Juan. Let me try and restate what I think I said earlier and where I think we are now in terms of progressing. The most important thing we can do is to complete the workshop selection process. The easiest and, frankly, the most responsible way to do that is while we're all here voice to voice, face to face. It's impossible to do this sort of thing in virtual and through email chains. So. I actually think we're very close, and I think we probably have enough information processed through the Secretariat that we can drive ourselves to that discussion as well. So let me just explain how I think this might work. we could ask the Secretariat to put up, let me go back to the first. The first point is, I think we've accepted 85 in, unless we determine over the course of the next hours to move some out because we go back and we look at merger or we think there's a strong imbalance in some place, we want to correct something. I think our operating assumption on the basis of the broad diversity of the MAG and all the work they did and the very high scores for a small number, that those 85 are in, or there may be 83 or something, whatever the exact number is. But it's pretty much the top 85 that were in the spreadsheet that came from the Excel. And I'm sure the Secretariat can tell me in a moment the one or two that we set aside that we're not going to pull in. I asked the Secretariat to put the profile up that compares the 85 to the full 260 so we can see if we're largely in line with what the community actually said to us was important and see if that identifies any particular imbalances. I think we should look at the spread of thematic tags for the 85 and the spread of thematic tags for the 260. Again, that should highlight whether or not there were any areas that were of interest to the community that haven't yet been pulled in. We also, by the way, have two conversations that are related to that. The first one is our title is Enabling Inclusive and Sustained Growth. So I think it should be quite clear that there is a significant focus on sustainability, whether it's specific to the SDGs or in general. And then typically we've identified what we called sub-themes. We did the process differently this year. Well, I have to say, actually, I'm quite happy with how it worked out because I was a little worried about trying to do so many new things in such a compressed period, but I think it's worked out quite well. I think we should identify what we think are the four or five main tracks so that people can move more easily through the program. And honestly, I think that's pretty clear as well, because I think that we get those through the thematic spread. The Secretariat is ready or may have already sent out the list of the groupings for potential mergers. Those people that had a lot of interest in that topic or felt strongly could suggest, which ones we might pull in or which ones were too similar and therefore need some adjustment. And if we don't get to the merger discussion completely today, then that's possibly one that we could come back online with a few exceptions. I'd rather not do that, but if we had to, we could. And then I think the other one is regional balances. So I actually think we have enough information in front of us that we can start to work through it. I have Jack in the queue and then Marilyn, and then I'd like to look for a sense of the room, and I do want to hear from the online participants as well, so if there's any concern or comments for them, Anya, do let me know, but whether or not we can move forward with that proposal. Changatai's got his hand up, and I always try to listen to Changatai, so let me give him the queue, and then we'll go to Jack.
I'd just like to remind everybody, especially from one's remarks, we don't have 25. The number of workshops we have is actually a function of the total duration of the workshops that we choose. At the moment, we've been choosing quite a lot, except for 13 90-minute sessions, and then the rest are 60-minute sessions and one 30-minute session. So the number of workshops that we can actually choose is going down, and my rough calculation is, it's like 18 or so at the moment, if we choose 18 90-minute sessions. So if we choose more 60-minute sessions, of course, we can choose more workshops.
And the total then would be 85-60?
Yeah. It's a moving target as well.
So I think if we use the planning number of 100 at this point in time, that's close enough. And
yeah.
Honestly, if we find that we've got a few extra slots, then maybe we can use that to pull a few other interesting proposals up. Jack, you have the floor.
Thanks, Chair. What some of us were trying to do yesterday was to look at the different tags, the thematic tags, and then pull them together by clusters and then make some kind of analysis in terms of whether they were from developing countries or whether they were new proposals, which were accepted, and whether there were any replicated proposals and replicated speakers. So that gives us a sense of, okay, so these are then potential mergers for those that we've already accepted if they were from the same proposals, for example, that came from the same topic. But it's actually quite labor-intensive. I don't know how far we've actually managed to go as a group. We tried to distribute this amongst ourselves. But it's a very useful exercise anyway that can somehow help for at least next year if we don't manage to do it for this time. But just to reinforce what both you and Juan were saying, I think it's extremely useful to look at the percentages of the thematic clusters that were accepted in the top 85 as compared to the total. That will identify some gaps for us. But just apart from that as well, looking at thematic diversity as an important thing, there's some that are completely new topics. For example, the one on wildlife trafficking, which I thought was extremely interesting, but scored really, really low. And I think we should take that into consideration in terms of the 18 or so that's left. And if we can get a sense of actually the 90 minutes and the 30-minute sessions and actually what amount of space we do have to make decisions, that could also probably guide us a lot better, because I know it's not as big as you think. And that for developing countries, new proposals, thematic issues and gaps, I would agree that these four criteria would be quite useful.
Thank you, Jack. And I appreciate all the work that the working group did last night as well. So any conclusions or opportunities you saw when you went through your report, you should pull it into the discussion one by one. And then maybe we can actually take that work back within the secretariat and use that for some final kind of calculation. And if we need to make some minor adjustments, we can do so on the basis of that information. Marilyn, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I'm focusing again on process, and I'm going to make sure that Juan is available and also Eleonora, because I've looked at the document that I think was forwarded from Sala, and I've got a couple of questions. One seems fairly important to me, but I first of all want to read a phrase. Inclusive and sustainable growth. Anybody recognize that? It's the theme of our conference. However, and this was not an easy decision to take, however, when I look at what we've done in clustering, I don't actually see inclusive and sustainable growth, which implies growth economically in terms of opportunity, not just growth in access, although that is also implied. Growth also should be implied in terms of diversity of participation, such as persons with disabilities, et cetera. I'm just going to comment on very quickly on Jack's comment. I'm not sure we can go as far as wildlife because I'm still worried about trying to get persons with disabilities in. But the other comment I'm going to make is that under the column SDGs that the group worked on last night, they didn't list SDGs. They listed the action lines. That's not a map. And I'm sorry to be so harsh about this, but we have an assignment that we were given when we got our 10-year mandate from the United Nations high-level event last year, and we were reminded of it by Undersecretary Wu, that we are to integrate the SDGs into our work. So, you know, I think we can try to map the action lines to the SDGs elsewhere, but our priority has to be the SDGs. So I think that was a very well-meaning thing, but I want to go back to when I look at, I think we are missing some workshops on that focus on economic growth, and I think because it's the theme, I want to put that in the list of those that we need to examine and perhaps move up. So that's point number one. Point number two, we may even have to consider reducing some of the 90-minute sessions or asking some of the 90-minute sessions if they would accept a 60-minute session in order to have more diversity and inclusiveness in the workshops. I appreciate everything that you said, Juan, about I think we do need to look about general regional perspective because we also know, and the Secretariat can remind us, that a very large percentage of the attendees will come from the Latin American and Caribbean region, and yet it is a global conference. So we need to have a balance of making sure we are being of interest to the communities that we are able to attract. But my particular concern is the fact we're not reflecting the SDGs and we are not reflecting the title. And I remember, and Yolanda, I am looking at the Mexican host, that for Mexico, in being a host, it is very important that we have a focus on the issues that that underlie the selection of that title. Thank you.
Thank you. And I hear your supporting points that were made earlier as well. So, I mean, I'd like to pretty soon move to actually getting into the substantive work. There are three more people in the queue. I'll take comments. I really would like, though, to understand whether or not we could go forward with the proposal that I outlined earlier. So, Juan, you have the floor.
Sorry. No, just a quick intervention. I want to support what Marilyn just said, and also to move forward, maybe that is not, I try to remain, how can I say, neutral regarding the Cuban proposals, but I have to explain because Marilyn brought it up. Of course, as you could presume, I did some outreach, and I even did some conferences in Cuba about the IGF and about the main topic of the IGF, that is this inclusive growth. And in that sense, there have been some proposals especially targeted for that. I can mention one, number 52, that is called Cuban Civil Society for Inclusion and Sustainable Growth, that it has exactly the approach that Marilyn said. This has the added incentive, that is the new civil society organization in Cuba, and that it's that concept is quite not new, but increasing in Cuba. So I will think, Chairwoman, that we should also maybe, if you accept the possibility that MAC members, not only me, point out some workshop that we already identify that it maps to what Marilyn said, or any other subject that we may think that is not well represented and that it should be. For instance, Cheryl mentioned medicine that I mentioned yesterday. Thank you.
I am in complete agreement and actually quite anxious to get to the point where we actually start talking specific proposals. So we have two more people in the queue, and then I'm actually going to ask the Secretariat to just show quickly the two profiles of the diversity from the 85 versus the 260 and the thematic spreads for those same two categories. So we have that as two additional data points in addition to those areas that people think are underrepresented and the merger document, which I believe has gone out. So Michael, you have the floor.
Just real quickly, to respond partly to Marilyn's comment, I do agree that we haven't talked enough about economic growth. I think we've talked a lot about sustainable development, and it's hard to say that we haven't included a lot of sessions that touch on that. The challenge, I think, is that when we try to cluster things, we try to go to finer grained topics as the action items are. But the main point I wanted to make is that in order to bring in some of the developing country proposals and some of the people who are proposing for the first time, I think we should focus almost entirely on picking out those proposals that did not make the cut, where there may be one or two people who could bring a particular project or a particular viewpoint onto another panel. I don't think we do them a favor if they have a weak proposal that we decided wasn't very good because it didn't have enough breadth and it didn't have enough expertise. We don't do them a favor by giving them a spot for their panel. They won't have a good audience. We do them a great favor if we take one or two people and add them to a panel that's going to have a ready-made audience, and I think that's the way that we should focus on getting more new proposers and more LDC participants, rather than trying to just have more panels that were proposed by LDC people. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael. Renata, you have the cue. Floor.
Thank you. Renata, thank you, Chair. Good morning. Speaking on behalf of developing countries and inclusions, I would agree that having less 90-minute sessions and suggesting that some of them go to a 60-minute session and having more diversity, more slots, would be good for inclusion of developing countries' proposals. And 15 proposals approved out of 260 from Latin America is very worried. We should think also that this lack of representation will dramatically disengage IGF from the region. About the spreadsheet we started working yesterday night and SDGs indication, this is also something that could be noted on the feedback of workshops. Many did not indicate this, and we should stress the importance of this also for next year. Mergers should also be an important part of our work today, since when we identify the thematic clusters, we already see some developed countries organizations that have two workshops on the same theme that were approved, that are highly ranked. So this is something that we should work on. And I am in agreement with following the chair's proposal earlier. Thank you.
Thank you, Renata. Giacomo, you have the floor.
Yes, I want, because we are discussing about development and about sustainability, I am on the same line of what Jack said before, that there are some workshops that have not been enough considered in the pointing that has been, in the grading that has been made by the members. And for instance, there is one that is the number 22 on local content sustainable growth that seems to me well balanced. There are a lot of interesting intervention, and it talks about contents and how the contents could be the driving force for the infrastructure. This is an aspect that we are completely neglecting in our selection at the moment. So I think that probably there is a problem of lack of comprehension of the diversity. We are so much focused on the internet governance issues in itself that we don't see around it or even at the base of it. And I think that this is a typical example of under-evaluation due to our prism of analysis of the world.
Thank you, Giacomo. I also understand that today is Giacomo's birthday, so I think we can all wish him happy birthday. I suppose we could all sing happy birthday in our own languages, and that would be quite interesting as an experiment, but... So happy birthday, Giacomo. We're very honored you're spending it with us here today. Liesl, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Good morning, everyone. I just wanted to make a sort of reaction comment to some of the comments that have been made this morning about the diversity of the workshops. I think it is very important to have robust representation from the region that the IGF is being hosted in any given year. But I don't think the sole indicator of that is how many workshops were proposed. Of the ones that are selected are those that were proposed by the region. I think that when we take a look at the diversity across, look at the diversity question, another indicator is also the number of the regional representation within participants in other workshops that may or may not have been proposed by the region. I think that in my grading process, I don't think we had a dedicated requirement for a certain number provided by the region or anything like that, but we did have a geographical diversity requirement across all the workshops. So I hesitate to think of us as only looking at that one indicator as of regional diversity, and rather looking across all of the workshops as a whole. And even if that requires at some point, you know, I made two comments yesterday about sort of the what we fix in post for either diversity or improving workshops or incorporating people from other places. That's another way to improve the diversity, the regional diversity across the workshops. Thank you.
Thank you, Liesl. I think it's time now to start getting to some specific.
Thank you. Just to follow up on the Latin American situation, yes, indeed, there's participation on the workshops of Latin American speakers, but also you see many of them working for developed country organizations and based in developed countries. So that indicator is also not very realistic when we talk about developing countries' inclusion and regional representation. The geographical diversity is very important, and I guess this is would be the way that I would agree that we should insist on this criteria, and maybe even think of other regions, Middle Eastern regions, for example, were not that represented. So we could start thinking about how to increase geographical diversity and have a more equitable representation of the, on the workshop's approval. Thank you.
Thank you. Sina, you have the floor, and then after that I want to move to a quick review of the thematic tags, and we need to start talking about some specific discussions. We're nearly an hour into the meeting here, and we've yet to to get to a substantive discussion on workshops. So, Zina, you have the floor.
Actually, I want to support what Renata said about the regional presence of the workshops, and certainly I would like to see some proposals from the Arab region accepted, because among the 85 I didn't see, although we have 21 proposers from the Arab region, but no one passed already.
And I think this would be a good time for you to specifically identify whether or not you think there are some proposals that should be put in front of the MAG for consideration. I have two more people in the queue, but could I literally just ask people first to look at the comparative view of the tags that are up there? One of the, I think, richest areas for us to mine, which potentially addresses some of the other questions about whether or not we've got enough workshops on economic or sustainable development or regional balance, might come from looking at some of those tags, either the new tags that were submitted by the community, or some of the tags that had a lesser percentage of proposals. We may be able to pull some up from those categories that address some of the larger kind of concerns we have here. That's one set of input. And then you all have the other graphs which show the diversity characteristics of first time versus returning, developed versus developing, and stakeholder groupings. That and any other work that as individual MAG members you have done that would you believe would identify some candidates to be included in the workshop proposal, this is the time to start talking about them. So I'd actually like some concrete proposals. We need to ask the other MAG members to be able to respond, look at your notes, your comments, and let's see if we can start making some headway into identifying the next 20 or so workshops. With that, I have Xiaodong Li and then Izumi and Cheryl in the queue. Xiaodong, you have the floor.
I have a very quick comment. I just want to second Renata's suggestion to consider diversity for the region and also the diversity for the stakeholders. I mentioned yesterday that we had lack of the persons for government or intergovernment organizations or private sectors. I strongly consider the involvement from the private sectors will play a very important role in the governance. And I also look at the persons for the regions. I think there's not enough persons for Asia Pacific. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Xiaodong. Izumi, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I agree with Liesl that it's not just the, when you actually look at the regional diversity, I think it's worth just not looking at where the proposal is coming from, but look at the content of who who the speakers are. And because when I was receiving like a consultation, I actually try to encourage people to have like regional diversity rather than focusing on a particular region. So it would have been much easier for people to submit proposal from Asia, but I just really encourage people, hey, this is global IGF, so it would be good to, you know, reach out to people from different regions. So I think that should also be taken into consideration. And I'd like to join the earlier speakers that like Arab or Asia Pacific, even if not like a developing country only, but like East Asia, I think our voices are quite limited. So it would be great if our like this factor could be taken into consideration. Thank you.
Yeah, I mean those are all good points. Cheryl, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I also wanted to put my support behind making sure that one of the disability proposals at least is included in the top final cut. I recall seeing at least two. I don't know if there were more. We had a whole discussion on how important this topic is last year, and a lot of them were knocked out and not included last year as well. So I would love it if we could not make the same, go down the same path and at least make sure that we're giving attention to this important topic. Thank you.
Cheryl, can you identify those workshop proposal or ID numbers so we can start talking about some specific proposals? And if you can't right now, I'm very happy to give you a few minutes to do so.
Were they? They were in? Okay, so Mike is saying they are in and they are accepted. So I would, both of them. So, okay, good. Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you. Juan, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Well, I'm going to break the ice and begin proposing concrete proposals and making a brief case for each. Of course, maybe this, I'm going to use proposals made by Cuban institutions because are the ones that I know, but this does not preclude that I could make proposals later if I look some other. Well, the first one I already mentioned yesterday. The importance why I propose it is because of the topic, because it's medicine, it's internet, how internet is used for medicine. And this is not a theoretical, this is not to talk about a new software of hospital automation. As you know, Cuba has thousands of medical collaborators in 67 countries throughout the world. And they use, because they are very in different places, hard, you know, rural, they don't go with books. They use internet and a network that is called InfoMed, that, by the way, it was many years ago, in 2005, the Stockholm Challenge Award. This is proved and tried and proved. They use this for getting consultation to do second opinion. So I think it's very important. I think it's very interesting. It could be a lot of interest. It goes with sustainable development goals. And the number is 81. Okay. Then the second one that I strongly propose is there's one that is called Cuban Civil Society for Inclusion and Sustainable Growth. I mentioned that before. It's a proposal of a flash session. So I think it could be included in whatever modality. It's number 52. And now I'm going to talk of one that I think is very important, that even could be one of the main themes maybe for the next IGF. As you know, the Sustainable Development Goal has a target for 2030. Have you figured out in 2030 how cyber things will be part of society? How that will be part of development, cyber society 2030? Well, a group of different Cuban NGOs did a panel on that, a workshop in Cuba, and they want to present their results. They have the Association of the Blind, they have the Association of Women, they have different associations. They presented a background paper that you can check there, because they did that before, and I think that is very interesting for you to consider. I just leave it to you to consider. It's number 48. And another one, that now that we're talking about sustainable development, that has to be carried out in the ground, in the field, in the local community. This is, by the way, these people that presented this was one of the first, it's number 25 because it was presented very early. It's the experience of different organizations in a locality in, for local development in the province of Santiago, the municipality of Santiago de Cuba. It's truly multi-stakeholder. There's an enterprise, there's civil society, and also government that they join together to use this internet and ICTs for a local development. They have a background paper that you can read, very depth, that explain what they're doing. It's number 25. Chairwoman, I will leave it there, but Giacomo was mentioning local content. There's another example, very interesting. If you want, I could mention that. It's called EcuRed. You know, it's a sort of Cuban Wikipedia, but it's not Cuban, it's Latin America. It's a Spanish Wikipedia. But the interesting thing is that it fostered local content. Many municipalities, the history of the municipality, the landmarks that are not recognized anywhere are recognized there. And it's open, it's Wikipedia, everybody can do it. It's called EcuRed. And it's proposal 36. And the problem is that when you read the proposal in English of those workshops, you can realize that some of those translations were done automated translation, so it's horrible, the proposal, and that is why it got so bad a scoring, because the ideas are really good. I will stop there. I'm not mentioning the educational, because fortunately, also the Ministry of Higher Education and Ministry of Education proposed open forums, so maybe the content of their workshop can be channeled through the open forum. But that is also another important sustainable development goals, the one related quality education for all. And I think that should be, we should take into consideration that, but that is also going through open forum. But this one, our civil society that cannot go through open forum, so that's why I'm proposing that. I hope, did you took the numbers?
I took the numbers.
Thank you.
I actually waited with bated breath for the first number. The numbers I have are 81, 48, 25, and 36. So Juan's made, a case for inclusion for those four proposals. My preference at this point is to try and get some discussion on those four proposals and see if there's any strong support or, I guess to the same extent, any strong objections to including them. If we just go through and gather a long list of 40, we're not going to make any progress. So let's see if we can manage to get some comments on those four specific proposals, deal with those, and then we can move to the next group, which means if you're in the queue but not specific to address those four proposals, then I would like you to reserve your comments for later. So I have, thank you to those that did so. I have Indonesia who's in the queue. But
Okay, thank you. I support the previous speaker. I would like to propose one of the title from Indonesia. There's the only one from Indonesia. If I can say that's ID number 101 or the total number is 160, the inclusive multi-stakeholder works to protect children online. That's only one title that proposed by our multi-stakeholder things. Okay, thank you.
I wasn't clear if the ID number was 101 or 160.
The total is 160 and the ID number is 101.
So ID number 101.
Yes.
Cheryl, you're in the queue. You have the floor.
Thank you. I was just looking through these proposals. I definitely would support one on number 81. I think, as we mentioned, the medical angle is not covered in any of the other proposals that I've read. I also see that it's a birds of a feather session. It's 60 minutes. It could be very interesting, and I think they're doing some very interesting work on that topic. So I think that there would be a good level of interest for that one. So definitely want to support that. I note that the one on Cuban civil society, it's a flash session, only 30 minutes. Also a pretty important achievement that they've made, and so I would support that one as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Cheryl. Very useful comments. What was the number of the flash session?
I think, unless my printouts are wrong. Thank you very much.
You have the floor.
Thank you. Yes, I'm going to read the comment from Sylvia Bidart. Speaking on behalf of developing countries, I agree with the suggestion of some 60-minute session and including more slots for developing countries' proposals. Economic growth and digital economy is a very important issue for these countries, so I would like to encourage everybody to include more workshops with inclusive development. Thank you.
Thank you, Sylvia. Igor, you have the floor.
Thank you. I feel heavily lobbied in favor of more Cuban sessions at IGF, and automatically I'm tempted to start doing exactly the same for the Eastern European front and saying, well, maybe we should be looking at more sections, very interesting sections from my region. But I'm not going to do that. And I thought, just wanted to sort of put out a call out there. If we do discuss these last few spots, that we actually focus on merits and on the content of these proposals, not necessarily the location where they come from. Otherwise, I will have no choice but start lobbying for Eastern Europe. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Igor. I mean, there's nothing much pretty about this process. And, you know, it's been the process that's been used for a few years now, and I think one of the recommendations is immediately coming out of this session, I'd really like to suggest that the MAG set up a working group to determine how we do this better and not wait until the next MAG is appointed and we start it in December, because we lose too much institutional memory and, frankly, the pain is probably too far removed to really convince us that we need to do something different. So I sincerely appreciate everybody staying with the process and trying to do the right thing. So at this point, I mean, Juan did break the ice by jumping in with four proposals. There was some support for 81. I really would like to get just a quick sense of whether or not there's significant support for any of the others or significant objections again. We don't need to pull all four in. We can choose to pull one or two in, note the others and set them aside and come back and revisit them if we find that there's a dearth of what we think is acceptable proposals. I mean, I don't think someone should be sort of unfairly advantaged for going first, but it is also important at the same time that we break the ice and start getting somewhat concrete about the choices in front of us. So I'll go to the queue, and if everybody could just keep the comments really short, you know, you support X for some reason or you don't support X for some reason, would allow us to make a lot more progress. Michael, you have the floor.
Thank you very much. And Juan, thank you very much for putting a concrete proposal out there, because I think you've hit about three or four different important issues we have to address. The first issue I wanted to address, Igor just addressed, we can't have people spending 5 minutes lobbying for things that they've been asked to lobby for. I mean, if we all did that, we would spend 3 hours doing that. I mean, you said yesterday that it's not appropriate to kind of come forward and make the case for your own proposals or for your friend's proposals. We have to argue on the merits, and Juan has four proposals that have merits, but not as panels or as birds of a feather. The reason they got low marks was because they could be part of a big panel, but they weren't covering a broad enough topic to merit a full panel. And we had a number of people do this, and they got low marks. That doesn't mean there isn't a place for them at the IGF. And I think our Mexican hosts have already provided a great way to highlight these important initiatives, and namely the lightning talks. Another possibility is some kind of poster session where people could share their individual experiences and talk to the people who care about that particular topic. I think another problem we have to face up to, though, is some of these proposals, including the Cuban ones, but there's probably several dozen, that really weren't internet. They were much more ICT4D. Some of these didn't even use the word internet. They didn't use the word internet governance. They were often about using cell phones or something else. So let's see if we can take some of the proposals that fall in this category and take the proposers and add them to another panel. Don't cut down a 90-minute panel that already has six people, but instead try to take some of these proposers and add them. And in specifically with regard to Juan's topics, those were not well ranked because they were not broad enough to excite a large community. They would be good as a flash session, and you would get to reach the people you need to reach. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael. There were good comments. I do wish we could be a little faster in them. Chengatai is suggesting we set a timer up for the comments, which I don't think is all that good because they're not all equal, but if we can all just manage to kind of direct and to the point comments, I think we'll be a lot better. Marilyn, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Very quickly, I'm going to propose that we all remember our code of conduct, and so here's my suggestion. Instead of using the word lobbying, we refer to what people are doing, which is providing clarifying information. I think that would help us all. and in fact, we all need often to be able to provide clarifying information. So I too appreciate that Juan did that. I'm going to make two comments quickly. I think when it's a totally unique proposal, and I believe that the one that Cuba submitted, particularly on healthcare, is totally unique because it is from a country, but it is a country that works globally in healthcare. So I am supportive of that one. I am just parking the idea that the sustainable development one perhaps might be put forward to think about a merger with another sustainable development and economic growth, and so I ask Juan to think about that. And I do think that a 30-minute flash session on a couple of other things that Cuba proposed, perhaps I think it's number 48, the IoT in 2030. So one idea for a merger, one support, and one suggestion that IoT for 2030 be a flash session and a call for us all to refer to us as clarifying.
So Marilyn, can you, I think that was useful because there were some concrete suggestions. Can you just put the recommendation with a number?
Sorry, I believe 48 is IoT in 2030, which I was proposing as a flash session. Unique healthcare, the unique one I was referring to, I believe is 81. And the sustainable development one will have to check me on this. I think it's 25. And that is the one I was proposing. No? The one for the merger I was proposing is sustainable development that you referred to as involving sustainable growth, yes. Sorry, that's 52. I apparently
Local development is 25. I don't know what you referred to.
It's the one it's economic, it's the economic development one, the one that referred. Okay, that is the one that I thought might be merged with some others that are focused on SDGs and economic growth.
Okay, so maybe I'm going to try and, again, because I want to make sure we get opportunity for other themes and other regions in the discussion as well. I've heard a couple of people speak out quite strongly for 81, and I'm not ignoring Michael's comment at all, but I do think there's a lot which is very reasonable, and particularly I think Cuba and medicine really is a really interesting area. So let me just see if I can... And I recognize fully that I am pushing this, and if it's too fast and we need more discussion, then please say so. But that we would support 81 going in, and we can work with the proposers to address that. We can look at 48 as a flash session, and now I'm going back to Miguel's comment earlier where he said, you know, those that were identified as flash sessions in the workshop proposals, perhaps we can reach out to them separately to become one of the lightning talk formats, which I think is a nice thing to do. And then there was a notion that we might merge 25. I think we can capture, if people are in agreement, we can capture those as kind of the current state and then come back and see if there's something else that adjusts that later. If it's a brief intervention, a clarification intervention, Juan.
Well, responding to Igor, I'm happy to propose some. I already identified some from Albania, Russia, and I don't find any more from Eastern Europe, only one that is between Holland and Lithuania. I think they're interesting. I could argue for that. If I lobby for one area, I can lobby for another. But I prefer what Marilyn said, that I'm only clarifying. Because really, what I'm stressing is the subject, the topic. And in this sense, the topic Cyber Society 2030, I think it should be, I don't know, I'm putting this in your hand, to be open, not only for Cubans to participate, because I think that is important for everybody, because it's a complement of the sustainable development goals, that the end of the goals is 2030. And it's very important to all of us to begin to think how it's going to be the cyber society in 2030. And
so, Juan, I'm not quite sure what your concrete proposal
I
is.
To try to do that as an open thing for not only for the Cuban participant, because maybe the Cuban participant will not be able to attend, to open to some other speakers that could join there. I don't
is
know which kind of session could be a more open thing, you know,
are you
for people
speaking
to.
Are you speaking specifically to one of the four workshop proposals which
yes,
we're trying to come to
yes,
agreement? What number?
48. I don't know of the all the formats, that, because you're suggesting a flash. Maybe it's not a flash. Maybe some sort of mini open forum, you know, something in which people can give their opinion of how cyber society will be in 2030 and
okay.
how do
okay.
we get there.
Thank you. So I put a proposal forward. Again, thank you for your patience, everybody. I understand I'm pushing this forward. Is there any objection to moving forward with 81 as a workshop? Jack, do you have a comment specifically to that? Jack, you have the floor.
Thanks, Chair. I think the reasons that's already been given for supporting it, in that it speaks about health and that's quite critical, is good. But one of the biggest shortfallings around the Cuban proposals was that it's very singular. There's no different stakeholder groups or different like regional representation. So I would say a conditional acceptance with recommendation to bring in other people.
Okay. I see, with apologies to those that are online, I see lots of heads nodding in the room that would be a good condition to put on it. And with that, I think we have support for 81 going forward and 48 to be evaluated as a flash session, or we can set that to the side for now, Juan, but I didn't see a lot of support for that coming in. So I've got quite a long list of people in the queue. If you want to speak specifically to these four, then I'll let you come in. It needs to be a substantive new point, though, so we can move on to some other topics and regions. So if you're not speaking specifically to that, would you please take your flag down, your electronic flags down? And now I'll come to the top of the queue, which is Giacomo. That still leaves six people in the queue, so please, let's be right to the point. Have the floor.
I will not abuse my prerogative of birthday, but it's very... No, I have a different proposal, if I may. I think that, first, this year Cuba is important, that we deserve a special attention to Cuba, and there is no reason to explain you why. I think that is clear to everybody. But what I've suggested in my remarks and proposal of merge, I said first that it would be good to have a workshop in which this kind of interesting experience are explained, so a sort of a window where we can see what is happening in Cuba, because This is something of interest for everybody. So if this different experience in different fields can be exposed and explained and discussed with the others, would be very interesting for everybody. And the second suggestion is, there are proposals that could be easily merged if there is a goodwill with others. For instance, the one about EcoRed that I pinpoint as an interesting one could easily fit within the workshop 22 about local contents. That's, I don't see any problem, and I don't think that is a problem for Cuban to join. This is what we have to do, to incite people to work together and to create bridges between various proposals. This, so it's going the direction what you say, but with some different angle.
Thank you, Giacomo. Renata, you have the floor.
Yes, Renata here. I'd like to address again the issue of regional representation. I support the 81 workshop moving forward. However, if the conditional acceptance is based on having more participation of other stakeholder groups, I would also point out that one of the clusters identified, which was big data, mergers were suggested, which were involving as well some Cuban proposals. So you have 58, 49, 53, 54, and 42, which are all about big data used for human rights and for common good. So this would be a merger suggested. Another merger, which was already agreed upon by another MEG member on the spreadsheet, was 187, 69, and 68, who have all been approved. And they are about big data and cities, big data and environment. So this could also merge with health and infrastructure. So again, the issue that health not being represented is has to be taken into account. And I disagree with the observation that we should not have regional representation. One of the IGF criteria is geographical diversity. If we do not have geographical diversity on the workshops, we are doing something wrong. So I would recommend we think about this, align merits of the workshops with geographical diversity. Thank you.
No, I do think that's an important point, and I'm sure the Secretariat is noting it, and we'll get back appropriately with those that we've identified with conditions. Izumi, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I actually have a comment, like a general observation about the process itself. I share like the comment mentioned earlier about like people suggesting for the workshop that they're involved, and I also feel like, you know, I would like to do the same, you know, and but again, I wouldn't. And I can certainly like provide what seems to be objective, like information about the workshop that I has been involved in consulting, because I know well about it. But not everybody will have a chance to do that. So I want to be clear about the process. So I think if others are, you know, are suggesting, you know, the people who are not involved in the workshop is proposing, you know, this should be like consulted. I think that's a fair process. But if you are involved in the workshop, even if you have, like, you're able to share, you know, what objectively is worth consideration, I feel this process is not really fair. And having said that, I think a lot of the Cuban workshops is very interesting, so I support, you know, incorporating that. But I think this should come from other people who are not involved in a consultation or involved in the workshop or accountability of our process.
And I think that's been addressed by a couple of speakers. I mean, I do appreciate Juan jumping in and breaking the ice and putting some concrete proposals forward, because it took us an hour to get to that point. So, no, Juan, I know I was going to say that.
And they responded, but neither I revised the anything. I didn't do it.
So Juan wasn't, he mentioned that he wasn't directly involved in those. I think regional balance is an important consideration. We did want to specifically look at that, include some in. I think it was a good start. I think we do all need to ensure that we're not lobbying for our own proposals or simply looking at those from our country or our organization. That's a principle we've always adhered to and one we need to stay with. And I do actually see intent in the room to stay with that. So I'd really like to close on these few very quickly so we can move to another maybe thematic grouping or regional grouping that we can address. I still have five people in the queue, though, so please, please keep your remarks to the point, to the topic that's in front of us, and brief. Xiaodong, you have the floor.
It's a very long queue. Firstly, I want to support Michael's suggestion. Just add so many proposers which failed the selection to join other sessions to be the speakers or panelists. Second, I also support the proposal 81, I know, but I also support Jack's suggestion to add more people into this workshop. But third, I think it's maybe I missed the opportunity, but I strongly suggest the MAG member to consider the proposal number 144, which is in line 161, to enabling every user with a unique internet culture ID. I think it's, this proposal is more concrete and more constructive and more specific. It's be easier for people to understand, and especially it's a joint session with different stakeholders. It's a joint session with a technical committee, private sector, and also intergovernmental organizations. So I think we should encourage the joint collaboration in the workshop proposals. And third reason is the universal acceptance is a very key issue for the internationalized domain, and also the email address internationalization to be successful, which is a very key issues before or after the island transition will be happened. Maybe we assume maybe happened in September or October. So that'd be very key issues. I strongly support that MAG member can consider that. Thank you.
Oops. Now to the online participant. And I mean, again, when the online, Anya pushes her button when there's a request for the online participant and you are being slotted, it's all electronic, you're actually being slotted in the order. I think there might have been some concern as to whether or not they weren't being pulled in appropriately. But
so this is a pending comment about workshop number 164 and 127. From Aida Mahmutovic. My strong support goes for 164 because it does speak from a developing country perspective, and I strongly believe it needs to be prioritized. My second support is for number 127, both of them are focusing on important topic, which is sexuality. I believe we will all agree, especially after last year's IGF in Brazil, how important gender issues are as thematic falling under Goal 5. And they also speak about safety and access to information. Therefore, once again, my strong support for 164 and 127, and thank you for giving a bit more space for remote participants and those present from developing countries in advance. Thank you.
Thank you, Aida. Julian, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Just going back to in my notes and evaluations and not making any changes on that, I would recommend to include the 52 session, which is a flash session, and also I support Jack's, Renata, and other comments to support 81 proposal, but including other stakeholders. And not just just to represent a more broad regional representation. Thank you.
Thank you, Julian. Sina, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would like to propose for all of us to reconsider the workshop number 165, because it's proposed by a new proposer It covers the whole Arab region. It's a report detailing the ICT situation in the whole Arab region, and it's based on five SDGs. So it was to be considered, please.
Thank you, Zina. I have four more people in the queue. I'll take them in the queue. And then when people are putting forward proposals, I think identifying the title and the number right up front is very helpful, as Zina just did, because then we can all pull them up quickly and look at them. And then we'll come back and figure out how we process our way through those. Sheeta, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would like to support the proposal number 193, Digimon, responding and analyzing threats to digital rights. It is also part of the standard deviations, top 30. It is flash session. This is very relevant for Malaysia context. This is in Malaysia. And the organizations that support this initiative is also helping other Southeast Asian organizations. So I really support this proposal. Thank you very much. 193.
Thank you, Sheeta. Sorbanan, you have the floor, please.
Is this working? Okay. Thank you, Madam Chair. I would like to put forward a proposal to the MAC to reconsider proposal number 250, titled How to Make Remote Participation Sustainable. As far as I could see, this was the only submission tackling specifically the topic of improving online participation at IGF and specifically targeting youth. Also, the proposal came from a developing country. And now I applaud and share your dedication to online participation, Madam Chair, but I hope you also agree that we need to do more and get better at online participation. I know that this topic will be discussed at the forthcoming IGF retreat. I think I saw a related agenda item there. And by the way, this retreat should also be streamed and transcribed. But to return to topic at hand and to reiterate, I think we should support proposal 250. And create space for discussion on the topic of online participation at the IGF. Thank you.
Thank you. I personally would strongly support that. and we'll come back and do a quick call on that in a few moments. It's quite a lengthy queue now, so if I can cut it off at Marianne, just so we can assess where we are and try and take some decisions on those that we've received so far. So in the queue, I have Cheryl, Liesl, Hassam, Jacques, Morad, Renata, and then Marianne. Cheryl, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I have three proposals that I'd like to mention and receive some comments on. The first, we started a discussion on yesterday. It was proposal number 27, We Protect, Combating Online Child Sexual Abuse with the MSM. I noted that it was a new proposer. It is an extremely important topic. I know that there are some others that are also similar, but not exactly the same as this. What the UK is doing is really quite interesting. This is a capacity building session, and I think that I'd like to strongly support this one as a first one, please. And secondly, I note Giacomo's comments on content, and given the fact that it is his birthday, also would like to support, seriously, though, the local content issue is very important to include. I don't know whether or not 22 can be merged, but it's a debate format. It looks like it could be very interesting just in terms of the description and the way it's set up. Perhaps in terms of fitting it in, maybe we can shrink it from 90 minutes to 60 minutes, but I think that would be another one worth discussing. And then finally, number 111, empowering and educating the next billions of internet internet users. This one is a breakout group discussion, and also a very important topic on the education angle. It looks like it has a number of well-balanced speakers that are proposed, good diversity, and would also like to have some discussion on this one. Again, this one is 90-minute. I don't know, for those, as we're trying to fit everything in, I don't know if there's any flexibility in, maybe shrinking some of the 90s to 60s, but would like some further discussion on that. Thank you.
Thank you, Cheryl. Can you just tell me what the first ID number was again? We've got 22 and 111 as your second and third.
It was number 27. So 27, 22, and 111.
Great, thank you. Liesl, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Is this an okay time to support ones that have been given, put forward? I would like to support 164. I had given it a 5, actually, a high ranking, so probably no further need for explanation there. On 165, I had also given that a high mark. One comment I made is that it could maybe be improved by having a government speaker, if I may say, but also a government speaker that might, or somebody that works in the region, even if they aren't, who works on the region, even if they're not in the region, might be interesting, but I would support it regardless. On 127, I do want to support it. I didn't give it a high mark, but I made a comment, which I think supports my ability to support it today. I said this workshop proposal doesn't present the diversity in its participants or speakers. It would be of interest, but perhaps it could be a flash session rather than it's described as a tutorial for 90 minutes, which I thought might be a bit long. So if maybe it has some adjustments in its format or participants, but in any case, I would support those three going forward. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Liesl. Hossam, you have the floor.
Yes, I would support proposal 144, which is enabling every user with a unique internet culture ID. It does cover local content, multilingualism, and it's very unique. So I think it's very important. One thing is suggestion is to increase the speakers' diversity a little bit. But other than this is a very important topic to cover. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Hossam. Jack? You have the floor.
Thanks, Lynn. Is it okay to suggest new proposals now, or are we just recommending? Okay, it's fine. Okay, so I'm sorry if it's quite a lengthy one, but I just wanted to say I also support 164 and 127 for the reasons already said. And just as a comment, I'm really very pleased to see the large number of workshop proposals that came under gender issues, whether as primary, secondary, or third tag. And also the amount of workshop proposals around online violence against women. And I think that also speaks a little bit to the impact of the best practice forum, if I can say so. I think it really does matter when it's presented that this is an important internet governance topic, and therefore then it sort of opens up the space, and then people kind of want to bring this topic into this space. And I think that's something to note, and it's quite heartening. saying that, I have 4 workshop proposals to suggest. One is specifically around gender issues. I think there's about 15 workshop proposals in total that sort of looks at gender issues, and about 5 has been accepted. So I think we can make definitely some space for that. And the one that I want to propose is actually workshop number 11. It's quite low on the list. It's a bit of an outlier, but I think it's important because it brings in new stakeholder groups and issues into the space. One, it's Francophone Africa, and I think that's an important region, and I didn't really see any on this topic so far. And secondly, it focuses on young women. So I think that also is quite an important thing to kind of try and support, because it's really quite targeted and specific, and it could be about language issues that the workshop isn't quite written in a particular way, but I think that's valuable to have a look at. Secondly, is also around new stakeholder groups and issues, is 237. Artistic freedom and cultural expressions online. I think this really broadens the topic of freedom of expression as well, brings in a very important component around expression that links to SDGs on cultural expression. So I think that's useful to have a look at. And another one is, again, on new issues into IG, is the one on 124, multi-stakeholder cooperation against illegal wildlife trade. I think that's highly interesting. It looks at data mining and big data in relation to trafficking of wildlife. I don't think it's a topic that we've really tackled very much in the IGF space, so I think it's really an opportunity to broaden and open this up. And finally, 124. And finally, on workshop 134, which is Assemblies and Associations Online, Coping with Challenges, because I happened to look at the human rights cluster yesterday, I noticed that there were a few gaps within the human rights clusters, and one of them is really around freedom of assembly and association. That's not covered at all. And if I may, the second gap in the human rights cluster is around application of human rights in law. So that's also not covered so far, so maybe that's also something that we might want to look at. And before I give up my space, sorry for being so long, just a little comment on Mike's comment earlier, that ICT4D is not something that's relevant for conversation here, that it's distinct from internet. I'm not sure I understood what the distinction was in relation to the comment, but I just wanted to emphasize that it is very linked, and I don't understand the distinction, if that was indeed the intention. And I don't really want to, like, you know, have a dialectic discussion about this, but just wanted to emphasize that it is quite key and that it links quite strongly to SDGs, and I don't really see the distinction at all.
Thank you, Jack. That was very helpful, and I'm glad you started bringing in some of the other thematic areas that we needed to look at as well. Michael, your intervention is brief and specifically to that point?
Correct. I just wanted to say that my point was that if you go to an ICT4D meeting or you go to a WSIS meeting, you will see a lot of discussion about computers without internet, cell phones without internet, and that's outside the realm. And some of the proposals that I was addressing were ones that didn't even talk about internet. But I fully agree with Jack that internet is fundamental to ICT4D. It's just that not all of ICT4D is internet.
Thank you, Michael. Murad, you have the floor.
Just want to second Zaina regarding the proposal of workshop 165. It's important for the region, as the region is facing a huge, MENA region, facing huge challenges in terms of youth unemployment, economic diversification, and I guess digital empowerment is very important for the region. Would like also to invite the group to consider the inclusion of workshop 16, internet access in the poor areas of the MENA region, for a flash session. Thank you.
Thank you, Murad. Renata, you have the floor.
Yes, I would like to address gender issues as well. Supporting workshop 127 and 164. I would, however, note that workshop 127 also refers to LGBTQ issues, so I'm not sure how or a merger should be done here. There's only 164 as well, but there's a freedom of expression, while 127 is a technical community workshop. So these are the only two proposals that mention LGBTQ, so I think they should be noted. And I would bring up again 169 about the effect of an IGF in the region. We have been discussing this issue of regional grouping exhaustively, but I again would like to stress that it is about regional diversity and bringing it onto the IGF and also in the aspect of ICT4D. And for the wildlife workshop on 124, if the issue is getting more stakeholder groups and diversity, I would again recommend turning to the big data cluster, which deals with environment and cities. So there should be an interesting mix to bring the people who are working with big data and environment and the wildlife and internet proposal. That would be it. Thank you.
Thank you, Renata. Marianne, you were at the top of the queue. You've now dropped down a little bit further, but as I had said, I was going to draw the line under you and then try and catch where we are. I'll come back to the queue, so the rest of you stay in, but I think there's starting to emerge some consensus on a few that we should capture. So, Marianne, you have the floor.
Yeah. So I would like just to support workshop 250. And there is a message from Ginger. She said that the workshop is poorly wrote and it should be developed further. And I do support that because remote participation is important not only for youth and development countries, and our face or our online meetings and all our communication online show that it is important to discuss various modalities, and it is closely connected with digital literacy of all of us. So I think it should be worked more, and it should be included into the list.
No, thank you, Marianne. So let me see if I can try and capture where I think there's support for a few, and then we'll continue back to those that haven't had any comments yet. There were quite a number of people that came in. Well, we'll take 250 on the remote participation. I also looked at that one. I think there's some good speakers, and I think with Ginger's comment and engagement as well. I mean, I'd like to put that forward as one we include. It's so critical, and obviously we're not doing that as well as we need to. There's support for that? I'm assuming support from the online participants as well? Okay, then we'll roll that one in. There was pretty significant support for three other sessions, 164, 165, and 127. If it helps, we can try and pull up the names of those quite quickly. But I'm assuming that in the background, those were some of the earlier ones which were put forward, that people had looked at those and had a chance to comment or support or object. Are people comfortable enough with pulling in 164, 165, and 127? Each one of those have had at least three interventions supporting and none against. So this is a chance for the online participants as well to raise their hand if they have anything further they'd like to add. Otherwise, I'm looking at people here in the room, and I see Christine has asked for the floor. We'll give her the floor and then see if we can close on those three. Christine, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Yes, speaking for 165, I think maybe one thing we could suggest to them is maybe include a business sector participant, because maybe that is one of the things that are lacking. But beside than that, I see there are so good speakers that are involved in the NRIs of the region, and I also see that the topic is about sustainable growth and inclusion. So it actually goes quite good, and they are newcomers. So I think some guidance, specifically on adding maybe a speaker from the business community, would help well to make it a good and strong workshop. Thank you.
Thank you, Christina. And I'm sure the Secretariat will give that feedback. Liesl had also suggested that we either get a government or a regional speaker that could speak from that perspective as well. So I'm sure that will be fed back to them. So I'm looking to close on 164, 165, and 127 on the basis of the support I've heard for it. No objections. We're going for a close then on those. Sorry, there are still a number of other proposals that were put forward that we're still looking for some additional comments on. We can go through those numbers quickly if that helps. I hope people have been noting them and looking in the background, but would it help to go through the numbers quickly? Again, these are proposals that people have specifically put on the floor with reasons for why they thought they should be included. So the numbers I have were 16, 144, 52, 169, 119, 27, 22, 111, 11, 237, 124, and 134. If you could, for the moment, try and confine our comments to that batch, then we could perhaps open up another wave. Is there anyone? I've got five people in the queue. I'll come back to the queue now, and I certainly hope it's actually on some combination of those proposals that are in front of us. So, Michael, you have the floor.
Yes, mine was actually on Jack's suggestion regarding 124, which was on wildlife and the use of the internet for selling of things like rhino horn. I didn't rank that very high. It's an interesting topic, and it's a very interesting case study, but I think it would only make sense if that was combined with at least two other sessions on the role of internet service providers in filtering out bad speech or illegal activities. There's a couple related ones that might work with that. Two of them are on internet anonymity and hate speech. I think that was number 220 and 221. Another one that might be brought into it would be 217, which is on intermediary liability. This whole question of do ISPs have to filter the internet? So I would only support Jack's proposal if it was to take one person from that session and add them to this broader panel. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike. We can certainly hear if there are any other comments on that and potentially ask the Secretary to take it forward. I have Laura in the queue. Laura, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I wanted to also speak around that workshop, which was number 124. I scored it quite highly, and I thought it was quite unique when we were going through the scoring process. I'm not sure I quite agree with some of Mike's comments around some of the mergers. I think that changes the nature of the session that was proposed, and I think it changes how it was focused. But I would support inclusion of that workshop as it is.
Thank you, Laura. Xiaodong Li, you have the floor.
I still try to encourage my member to consider the proposal number 144 about the culture ID actually is internationalized domain name and email address to enable the multilingual internet, because you know in Asia, especially in China, that so many people cannot access the internet because of the language issues, and also how to enable the internet to support the multilingualized domain name and the email is very important. But up now, I can open the new GTRDs. There's over 50% is, and more than 60% is in Asia, this multilingual area. But now the universal acceptance issue is very a tough issue for the software vendor to support. I mean, this work proposal is a joint session with Microsoft and also with ICANN USG. I think it should be a wonderful proposal to consider. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. We'll call those clarification comments. I will point that out, that workshop actually does have speakers from Russia, China, Thailand, Japan, and it does have the private sector as well there for business. I think, you know, it is an interesting topic. I think we need to decide here whether or not there's support for including it or not, and maybe we can try and just look for support online as well as here in the room, either for including that or are there any strong objections? 144. Any strong, so either, again, I say support for. If there's not support, people should indicate that as well. But the title was Enabling Every User with a Unique Internet Culture ID. The tags were multilingualism and local content, access and diversity, and connecting the unconnected. I see some heads nodding around the room with respect to supporting it. I'm actually kind of keeping track of stakeholder support when I look for heads nodding around the room as well, so there's quite a good mixture there. With no further objections then, we'll pull that one into the accepted list as well. Elizabeth, you have the floor. Thank you, Jialong.
Actually, that was the one that I was going to just mention that I thought was really important because of the issue. I think sometimes we thought of the internationalization of IDNs as sort of one achievement, and I think it's important that we continue that dialogue. So thank you for moving that forward. The other one I had, I wanted to lend some support to was 111. You had asked for people to consider that. I'd like to support that one. And there's one other one that I wanted to mention that isn't actually already in your stack, so I don't know if you want me to use my moment of time. It's 199. It's involving it's looking at the RUGI principles, which are the UN principles on business and human rights. And I think it's really, in light of some of the proposals around the anti-corruption best practice forum and some of the new sort of topics we're looking at in that area, I think it's a worthwhile topic and proposal for us to consider, and a different angle on the human rights picture, but an important and engaging one for diverse stakeholders.
Thank you, Elizabeth. We have an online participant. Anya, you have the floor.
Thank you. Aida would like to support workshop 250, Renata 169 and 250 and 193.
I'm sorry, Hanya, that was just very quickly. So 250 is in. What were the others?
So 250 Aida, Renata 169, 250 and 193.
So I note for my notes here, I think 193 is a new proposal, so we'll put that in and put it in front of people, and 250 was already accepted. Thank you. Next in the queue, we have Marilyn.
Very quickly, I'd like to support 144. I would also like to suggest that 52, which is, I think, very similar to 271, which hasn't been mentioned yet, but in the next round I will mention it. It's similar in that it focuses on sustainable development, economic growth, so I would propose 52 be thought about for a merger. 169 is a flash. I can support that. 119, I have many questions about because there are several workshops that have at least two of the same speakers in them. And the topic is similar to similar workshops. I think 119 needs to go into a cluster, and we need to also be looking for just the same duplication of speakers that appear over and over. So then those speakers could help to, and in some case the duplicate proposers could help to get mergers. I have a very serious concern about number 11. I rated it very low, although I'm a big supporter of the topic, and I want to explain why. I think it needs to be merged or significantly improved. It is headed in the right direction on the topic, but it has proposed speakers. It's focused on youth and women, and the two confirmed speakers are male and well beyond the age of youth. And I would know because I'm 69. So my suggestion on that one, it needs to go into a cluster, be significantly examined and possibly merged. And then I just had one other one, which is 111, and I'm going to make a comment about, I think we need to be really, really careful that if we're talking about a workshop and we in any way have an affiliation with speakers or proposers, that we're very, very careful about making comments. I don't have with that one, but when I look at it, I think it needs merging. I really don't think, I think I mean 111. Let me make sure, because I went through this so quickly. I'm a little concerned. I believe it's the one about empowering and educating the next billion. I think it's, there are a couple of others that are similar enough in the area of digital education, and I think given the what's trying to be done here and the fact that it too is kind of limited in, I mean, it has an excellent direction, but there are two provisional speakers confirmed. So I see a lot of good ideas, but I don't see the what I would call spade work that some of the others did. So I put one more that I'll come back to when you open the queue again for new ones. That's 271 for a possible merger, and I've gone through my comments on the others. Thanks.
Thank you, Marilyn. Sheeta, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would like to clarify first that 193 was my proposal, so it was not new. The second one, I would like to support proposals number 250 for remote participation, because I think that's really an issue that we have. And also support proposals number 134, because I think assemblies and association is a topic of freedom of expression that rarely being discussed in this session. And then the speakers also very diverse from many from the global perspective. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Sheeta. And just to be clear, if we've actually taken the, you know, a consensus call on whether or not a workshop should be in, there's no need to come back in and support it. The six that I have at the moment are 81 with some conditions noted. Actually, quite a few of these had conditions noted. Number 250, 250, 165, 127, 164, and 144. So if you're in the queue to comment on those, it's not necessary. They are in, and any other conditions or dependencies are noted. Ilya, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I would like to also support Chair's mention of Workshop 111. In Eastern Europe, we see a lot of people coming online first time, and they don't have enough knowledge how to combat online threats, ransomware, malware. In Bulgaria, we recently had cases with viruses encrypting your hard drive, and people had no idea how to combat this. This workshop might need to broaden the speakers and maybe lower to 60 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you. Ephraim, you have the floor.
Hello, this is Ephraim. I just wanted to express my support to 134. As Sheeta has mentioned about assemblies and association online, and then also to talk about 234, though expressing that there might be a conflict of interest because of one of the proposals is from Access Now. Just wanted to highlight about SPL 234 that it's unique because it focuses on connectivity and human rights. Others focus on just connectivity. Thank you. So 134 and 234. Those are the ones I wanted to. 134 and 234. Thank you.
Thank you. I'd like to support actually proposal number 243, it talking about accountability in internet rate policy. I think it's a rare kind of proposal, and I think it also rated 96 in the serial, and it also talking about to be responsible or accountable in developing public policies. I'd like to support the proposal and for your consideration.
Thank you, Suman. We have an online participant, Anya.
Yes, Virat supports 111. And I'm sorry, there is just an additional comment that just came from Virat about this workshop. We had agreed that provisional speakers were perfectly acceptable for this stage of submission. We can certainly expand the range of speakers. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Virat. Just one second. Juan, you're asking to understand those which we have accepted this morning?
No, which are considered.
The ones we're considering at the moment?
Yes, because it's a big list and a check mark has also been accepted.
Well, and let me, maybe this is a good time. There are four more people in the queue, which I can allow them to go through. There's about four or so that are actually getting good support from the room, which I think I can also try and kind of call consensus on from the room and the online participation. And then that still is going to leave quite a long list of proposals. A number of them have just come up, so people haven't had the time to respond to them yet. So maybe if you could give me one more minute, Juan, take these four comments, and then we'll draw a line under those that we think we have consensus on and start a new group. Does that work? Flavio, you have the floor.
Thank you, Lynn. I would like to support two workshops. One of them has been already mentioned. It's 191. He's well-ranked, position 97, in the top 100. It deals with an issue that I think it has not been covered by the other workshops already accepted, which is the regulation of OTTs. It comes from the private sector, which has not too many proposals accepted so far. And the other one is the 195. It's also relatively well-ranked, position 123. It has not been mentioned yet. It deals with innovation in the digital economy and its role in the Sustainable Development Goals. I think it's important. Also comes from the private sector and it's well-ranked in
Thank you, Flavio. Cheryl, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I also wanted to support 199. I went back and looked at that. I think it'll be a pretty interesting discussion, and so would want to put my support behind that. I just wanted to make a comment because there were a few comments that keep circulating about whether or not people are connected to workshops, et cetera. Aside from the fact that I know all of you in the room, I'm not connected to any workshops, so I just want to put that out there. Also, with respect to speakers, I know there were a lot of first-time and new proposers that explained to me that it's really difficult getting speakers that far in advance. And I think we did agree that, as Virat mentioned, having speakers that are provisional would be okay. And I would hope that we would see some flexibility on that issue. Thank you.
Thank you, Cheryl. Michael, you have the floor.
Yes, I wanted to support very strongly Flavio's suggestion that we support 191 on OTTs. This is an incredibly hot issue in many places. And also want to throw my support behind 134 on assemblies. I do have a concern about, I think it was 193, which was suggested. It's a flash session, but it's a very narrow session, and it's really about one project from one group. We had probably 15 or 20 of these types of proposals. Many of them were interesting, but they don't merit even 30 minutes. Again, I think that'd be a great fit for lightning rounds. And the last thing I wanted to talk about was a proposal that was in the top 100, but we haven't talked about yet. At least I haven't heard us talk about it. And that is number 109. Which is about internet shutdowns, which I think, if combined with 107, which is on a related topic, would be a very strong and fascinating proposal. The number of governments that have shut down the internet in the last year has almost doubled. This is certainly a major problem. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael. Siobhan, you have the floor.
Yeah, support for 144. 155, 169, 119, 124, 134.
Just a little more slowly, sorry.
Sorry about that. I wanted to save some time, so. 144, 155, 169, 119, 124, 134, and 191.
And the last one was 101? 191. Thank you. Juan, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. Well, first, I would appreciate if we do stop in the way and try to see where we are, because there's so many, it's hard for me to check them all. You know, maybe we can have it in a table, or maybe for the during lunch to have a result. And now I want to add, because as I said, I'm not only adding from a special country, but because of IDEA. I want to add 83, and the name of the workshop speaks for itself. It's called Improving Stakeholder Representation in Multi-Stakeholderism. It's a very important topic for us. And I want to increase also 140, that the name is Internet for All, Improving Global and Regional Coordination. It has to do with the same topic. And for those who are interested in the details, that's been proposed by the World Economic Forum. So you can say that I'm doing lobby for the World Economic Forum. So that's something like that. Thank you.
Thank you, Juan. I have four more people in the queue. I'd like to take them, and then I think there's about four or five that have had really significant support in the room. I would cover those, judge whether or not there was support, and then I think we'll take up your suggestion, which is maybe to list those that have been mooted for inclusion, make sure people are clear on them. People can take some time over lunch, look through them, we can come back for them. And maybe just before lunch, we could actually have a quick introduction to the main session so that people can think of that as well, because that's the next item on the agenda. So think about that, and we can come back and see if that actually works as a proposal. I have three people left in the queue. So Izumi, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I'd like to join in support for Proposal 191. I think it's a very specific topic covering OTT. It's rare, interesting, and I think it's also like getting more attention. So I support having this proposal. I also would like to join in support for Proposal 165. I think this covers the gender issue, but then from the regional perspective, specific to the Arab region, which again is rare. So I think it's a good proposal. Also to be included, and I think the suggestion about a way forward that you've suggested, Chair, is helpful. And so I'd like to double check which are the ones from the top 85 that is accepted, and if there are any grey ones, I'd like to double check which are the ones. So thank you.
No, that's a good point. We'll come back to that in just a moment after the next two speakers. I have three speakers left, and then let's see if we can kind of wrap this up, close it up, so we can allow some of the work to go forward over the lunch break. I have Sheeta, Murad, and Huyan in the queue. So Sheeta, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I'll be very brief. I just want to comment what Mike Nelson was mentioning about flash session. If you see the description of flash session, it is a format that should be used for session where an individual organization wishes to inform the community about the work they have done. So it's really specific. Thank you.
Thank you, Sheeta. Murad, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I just want to second Juan from Cuba on the importance of workshop 83. It is at the heart of our work, so it deserves to be supported. Thank you.
Thank you, Murad. I noted the support for 83. Thank you. Julian, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I'm just going through my notes, and I would like to support proposals 124, 127, 164, 165, 111, 144, 169, 190, and 191. Thank you.
Thank you. And I think I caught all that as well. So the Secretariat is going to go through and identify, I think there were only two or three in the top 85 that weren't pulled in yesterday after we discovered that the four that we had asterisked and set aside did in fact have background papers. They just hadn't been pulled over into the evaluation table, but Changatai is going to confirm that now. To date, without taking into account this very last round, we've pulled in 81, 250, 165, 127, 164, and 144. In this last round, there's been pretty significant support, and I think I'll just do them one by one and try and look for any concerns with moving forward. And Anya, if there's a hand up that goes on from the online participants where they want to come in on any of those, just let me know. So there's been fairly significant support for 191 ZOTT. There have been at least six proposals that have come in, MAG members have come in supporting that. And the same thing for 134. There have been at least five or six that have come in supporting that one as well. So I'm just trying to look around the room and giving the online participants time to make sure we're in agreement with those two moving forward. There was significant support, and that would be four or more for 169, which I think was a flash session. One thing we need to do is to go back through the transcript and make sure my notes aren't all that complete, whether it was a flash session or it was, or if there were specific conditionalities on it. So if there are conditionalities on it, we'll go back carefully through the transcript and make sure we go back to the proposers. But that was, in fact, supported as a flash session. So that one goes in as well. 144 was in. There was quite significant support for 111. Again, I've got four people supporting there. A couple of conditionalities that I remember were perhaps looking at breaking it down from 90 to 60 minutes. So we would bring that one in as well if there are no objections. Marilyn, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chair. I continue to have an objection to this one, not to it being included, but I'd like to see it considered for merger or significant enhancement before it moves forward. I really agree, particularly because I work with NRIs and I work with ICT associations from developing countries, in particular from the Arab states and from Africa and Latin America, that this there's a great need for the underlying concept. But I'm not satisfied yet, and I think that it should be improved, and I think it could also be merged.
And I think that's not different from a lot of the other conditionalities that people put on them. I heard a number of, I guess I would say, sort of hard conditionalities. Not it would be nice if, but we support it, but we're looking for these changes. So I don't think that that proposal is any different. There's a couple that are a little questionable. There was Workshop 11, which was both had a gender aspect, African region, and young women. And Marilyn had made the point that the only two confirmed speakers were elderly male. I think clearly there's some work needed there. And I don't assess any kind of, you know, clear support for that in the room yet. The others all had, and I'll come back to that in a moment, the others all had, you know, perhaps one, either just the person who actually put it forward for consideration or one other person speaking in support of it. So with that group, and it's quite a large group, I'd actually like to just list what those numbers are. And I think at this point we can ask everybody to take a little bit of time over lunch, look at them. We come back after lunch, and hopefully we can go through quite quickly and just look for whether there's an appropriate level of support for them or not. One of the things I'd like the Anya, I see your hand. I'll come in a moment. One of the things I'd actually like the secretary to do when we're all done this, you know, nearly final or intended to be final list, obviously understanding that a lot of the proposals have conditionalities, is to go back and kind of recast the spreadsheet such that we can look at all the different diversities, regional and stakeholder and first time, and you know, all the diversities we keep. And if we see, and that will be made available to all the MAG members, and if we see any of the areas that are really sort of wanting, then I think we can open that back up within the MAG and try and identify some additional proposals that we might work with to bring them up to an acceptable state. So I just want to make people feel comfortable that since this is quite rushed, and I think we're actually trying to look at a lot of additional characteristics that we haven't pulled into past processes, that we will actually slow the process down a little bit, take a thoughtful look, and come back if we recognize that there are any significant gaps. So the ones that I have open, and unfortunately it's not an alphabetical order or a numerical order, and if I've missed anybody, please jump in. The ones that we've had proposed, but not sort of judging enough comment on yet, are numbers 101, 16, 52, 119, 27, 22, 11, 237, 190, 109, and actually there was a comment there that 109 might be merged with 107, so maybe we can look at those both at the same time. 195, 243, 271, 83, 140, 199, 193, and 234. Did I say 193? Yes. Did I? I want to come to Anya as an online participant, and then there are two more people in the queue. And if I've missed any numbers, do let me know. Anya, you have the floor.
Thank you. Can you please note the support from Ginger on 199 and 124? And from Alejandra Ramuspe, support for 140.
Thank you. Noted. Cheryl, you have the floor.
Thank you. Actually, in going through my notes, I think 27 was included. So I apologize if I caused confusion on that. And I'd also like to support 140. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Michael, you have the floor.
I just wanted a status check. Do we have any sense as to how many we've already included in and how many open slots we still have? Because by my count, we have probably three or four.
10 in. We have 10 in, and that would say roughly about probably 8 slots if we're working towards 100. What that hasn't assessed yet is whether or not they were 30-minute slots versus 90-minute slots.
Okay.
But roughly that would be about another 8.
So in this last round, we're going to have to radically change our behavior. We're going to have to reject about 80% of these.
I think we can at lunchtime look and see if there's room for a few more, or if there's strong support, we could always put them into a kind of a holding category, because some of the earlier suggestions for mergers and that sort of thing might in fact not be taken up, or even some of the conditionalities. That would actually give the Secretariat a little bit of leeway once they have the time to actually sit through and look at the length of the proposed workshops. Would it be possible for the Secretariat to reorganize the spreadsheet and put the top 85 and these additional 10 or so that we've put in, so that we'd now look and, you know, the top 95 are the ones that are in, and we could and get that out?
Yeah.
So if we could actually do that in the background before lunch, that would help people's participation. I guess if we had our wishes, maybe we'd even highlight the 95 or so that we have agreed at this point are in, and then include the next 15 in a yellow lining or something, so that everybody had them right there in one row, and those next 15 or whatever would be easily accessible. Perhaps one person doing the work rather than 50 odd would be a reasonable savings. So are there any other comments on this process. My proposal was that we take the next half hour and ask, I'm assuming it's Liesl or perhaps it's Virat if he's still online, to just introduce the main session topics. Again, that will allow us to think about it a little bit over work or if there's any additional work we need to do to try and move that forward. I think we can make good progress on the main sessions. I also think those are activities we're going to need to move forward into the virtual MAG meetings anyway and continue to track them over the future meetings. So if we can make a really good start on them today, I'd consider that success. Is everybody okay with that as a plan? Liesl, are you ready to introduce you? And my thanks to everybody this morning for sticking in with the process and continuing to stay with it through the rest of the afternoon. Thank you.
Sure. As very similar to the comments I made on Tuesday in the open consultation, thanks to everybody for submitting their main session proposals. We have 9 proposals, and I'm a little bit unsure how that fits with the number of slots we have or don't have, depending on length of time and things like that. So I leave that to the group. Just one thing I'll say as main session working group co-leads, Virat and I, and this was part of the deal when I agreed to do it, that the workshop, the main session proposals are really, we collected them they went to the secretariat and we collected them, reminded people to put their proposals in, but we are not in the business of assessing them except as the co-leads for the working group, but rather in our, you know, sort of mag seat role. So, but anyway, let me just remind you what the proposals are, and perhaps I could also ask the secretary to send the updated compilation with the 9 before lunch, so that as you're reviewing things and we'll be assessing the the proposals, maybe you can take a quick look at it as well. The first is toward an interoperable global intranet network, solving current problems on cyber jurisdiction, proposed by Indonesia. The next is connecting the next billion, phase 2, proposed by Constance Baumler. Next, sustainable development, internet, and inclusive growth, Hossam Al-Ghamal and Elizabeth Thomas-Reynaud. Trade agreements and the internet, Jeremy Malcolm and Renata Aquino-Ribeiro. I hope I didn't get too far off on that, Renata. Sorry about that. Dynamic Coalition's main session by Avri Doria and Marcus Coomer. Then Shaping the Future of Internet Governance, which I put forward, supported by Flavio Wagner. That was a workshop proposal 179. And just to iterate that would be a proposal to change it from a workshop to a main session. Assessing the role of internet governance in SDGs by Marilyn Cade and John Dos Santos. National and regional IGF initiatives, main session, Marilyn Cade. And then economic, social, and cultural rights, what are the implications for the internet and sustainable development by Jack and Ginger. The compilation that the secretariat has sent out and will remind you when they send it out again, has the proposal descriptions for each in the compilation. So I urge you to at least eyeball that at your convenience. Perhaps if you, Chair, I don't know if you want folks who have proposed workshops to say a few words about them now, or how, I don't know how you want to handle that, but many of them, if not all, are in the room, so I'm sure they'd be ready to do so.
No, I think that would be useful. We have 2 people in the queue that I'll come to in a moment, and Changitai has informed that there are 7 slots for main sessions with the 9 proposed. So we have ISOC, which I'm assuming is Constance, in the queue. Constance, you have the floor.
Thank you very much. With regards to the main session proposal, the idea really is to reflect the outcomes of the work we're kickstarting and that I presented yesterday during the day before, during the open consultations. In the main session proposal, it was also noted after discussing with some of you and with the IGF Secretariat that it could also make sense to merge this topic. Perhaps it doesn't need a main session on its own with the main session proposal on sustainable development. Another proposal could be, as we did last year, to have a main session on IGF outputs where we presented the best practices plus the policy options. A third option could be to have the main session sitting on its own, but as I said, not necessarily, it's not compulsory. Thank you.
Thank you, Constance, and thank you for all your efforts leading that work as well. We have Marcus in the queue.
Thank you, Lynn, and to pick up on Constance's remarks, which were very helpful and tie in nicely with what I'm going to say. We had an agreement in principle to have a main session on the best practices forums, but for some reason, inexplicable reasons, they fell through the crack and the proposal was never submitted after the call, not formally submitted, but there was an earlier agreement in principle to have a main session. And this could be one of the options, as Constance suggested, to have a main session on all the outputs coming from these intersessional activities. But I think it is important to give the best practice forums visibility in a main session. There is the interpretation in all languages. It will be reflected at the highest status in the outcome document in whatever way it's being done. But I would like to put in a plea that we really elevate the best practice forums into a main session.
Thank you. Liesl, you have a comment on that?
Well, actually, my mic was lit for getting in the queue for the other proposal, but I did just raised a question for me, and I'm sorry, Marcus, if it didn't get captured in an earlier email chain. I know there was a lot of email chains at one point. And I guess just because I have the mic and Constance had indicated that there's flexibility in the way that we might handle the policy options, it just strikes me that the policy options and the BPFs are both under the category of intersessional work and might be a nice complementary combination.
Thank you, Marcus and Liesl. And I think we can probably leave that as an offer at the moment until we go through. We did, to my belief, acknowledge at the first MAG meeting that, in fact, the BPFs were worthy of a main session. So I think it's just a matter of how and where they get slotted in. That work is incredibly important, and we've heard a lot of good comments about it. So I don't think this is fighting for a slot per se. It'll just be a matter of what's the appropriate way to manage all the main session requests. I have UNESCO in the queue.
Thank you. I have one question and some suggestions. First, I wonder if these main sessions are reserved for MAG member to propose and organize, or is it open for the stakeholder to provide inputs?
I think historically it's been the MAG members. Chengatai can correct me if I'm wrong, but I thought it was primarily to sort of assess those areas that were of most interest and supported the overall track and themes. I do recognize that I think one of the main session proposals this time came in from a non-MAG member. I don't know that we've been all that clear on that historically, so, and I tend to lean towards more kind of inclusiveness and flexibility than less. I think we should look at that proposal, judge it on its own merit. But if it is accepted and does come in, then I think it is appropriate that it actually has some MAG membership in the coordination role as well. We have an online participant, Anya.
Yes, Virat, you have the floor now. Virat, can you try to speak now?
it's very late.
I'm
Virat's
seeing
time,
that Virat
so
is speaking, but we can't hear him. So maybe we can come later to this, and we're going to try to fix this.
Thank you, Anya. I also appreciate that it's very late where I believe Virat is as well. So appreciate his support and participation. Next in the queue, I have Marilyn.
Thank you, Chair. Marilyn Kate speaking. I just want to clarify that I am speaking now as a MAG member who made a joint proposal for a main session on assessing the role of Internet governance in SDGs. I know my name is shown as having proposed two, but in the second one, which is the NRI session, I am acting as the scribe with Anya. I can come back and talk about that at a different time, but now I'd like to focus on this main session. The write-up will be updated very shortly because this session is proposed to be conducted in a similar fashion, for those of you who were there last year, as the WSIS Plus 10 interactive consultation. It's a joint proposal from myself and from John Deere, and we have invited Sheeta to represent civil society so that we have at least three co-organizers. The effort will be to take the similar consultation approach, but we have added an enhancement of inviting David Suter, who is an expert in SDGs, he has confirmed, who will give a 20-minute sort of overview about what the SDGs are and some of the examples of how SDGs and internet governance are related. Since we are not talking to SDG experts, we're going to be talking to over 2,500 very diverse people, and this will help them in their preparation. We will also do a background paper, as we did last year, and we will have guiding questions, which will both be published, but will also be available in paper form when people register so that they will be able to see them. The first part will be an opening statement from the host, a description of the format, then we'll go to the overview of SDGs, and then we will go to the open mic using probably five mics this time, because I'm hearing from our Mexican host and from others that we'll have a significant amount of academic attendance. So rather than trying to put both civil society and academics all at the same mic, we would try to have additional mics. The mics are labeled, people have limited talking slots, and we'll divide the SDGs into segments. So people will be asked to comment on SDGs 1 through 5, for example. We'll have multiple rapporteurs, and there will be heavy reliance on the use of guiding questions, so people are making comments about their interpretation about how to achieve the SDGs and how internet governance relates. We plan to invite Ambassador Fonseca, I'm glad he walked back in the room, just as I mentioned his name, as one of the co-moderators, and then we'll invite one of the ambassadors from New York who's heavily engaged in the STI work, so that we will have the same sort of setup we had last year where we had some New York high-level attendance, and then we will have Ambassador Fonseca and one other co-moderator who will manage the rotating from microphone. If you remember, we go 2-minute speaking slots or 3-minute speaking slots that goes in alphabetical order, business, civil society, so to start academic, business, civil society, we can make around the mics, and that way nobody dominates. We will take remote contributions, and we will then have a summing up by a group of rapporteurs that will be drawn from the MAG members and others who volunteer, and we will have an orientation session for those rapporteurs both online ahead of time, and then we will expect to have our session report that will be available for a quick readout from our co-moderators in the room, and then also, of course, published in the overall IGF meeting report. Happy to take any questions, and I believe John Deere is here, and Sheeta, who's just been able to say yes to our invitation, is also here.
Thank you, Marilyn. Would you consider adding a 6Q, which might be youth, particularly since this is SDGs and
excellent idea. Perhaps Chair will start anti-alphabetically and start with them.
I think that would be great. they're the ones, of course, that are living, will live the longest with the world we're leaving them. Izumi, you have the floor.
Thank you. So as someone who's involved in the IPv6 best practices, I obviously have no objection to having a dedicated session on the best practices forum. But I'd like to make an observation that it covers really like a wide variety of topics. You know, certain best practices are around like access and others are around gender. So I think when we plan it as a main session, we have to make sure that it doesn't get scattered and people like have clear structure. Idea on what actually is the output, and I do see the value in that, on having people have clear idea on what were the output of each of the best practices forums without participating it. But I think that's something that we can consider. And another thing is that I think we have quite strong synergy with some of the main sessions being suggested, for example, connecting the next billion. I think last year we actually provided feedback to on that. So I think we can also consider like how best practices forums can feed to the main session that has a strong synergy to their theme.
Thank you, Izumi. Herman, you have the floor. Could you give the floor to Herman, please? German, maybe?
Yes. Thank you, Madam Chair. It was also my recollection that at some point we agreed to include the best practice forums as part of the main sessions. We're trying to look in the records, but I couldn't find it. So that's what my understanding. So I would be supporting what Marcus also explained before. I think the same nature of the best practice forums offer tangible outputs that I think would be good to show during the main session times. And additionally to that, well, we need to also to be careful to and have the main sessions that are our flagships and the more visible content in the agenda to be aligned with the main theme that we agreed in our first meeting in Geneva. Thank you.
Thank you, Herman. Liesl, you have the floor.
Sorry, user error. thanks. I just wanted to say a few words about the proposal that essentially I took someone else's really good idea and thought that it might be a very interesting main session. It was the workshop proposal 179, Shaping the Future of Internet Governance, and literally as I was grading it, I thought that it would provide, well, first of all, have a lot of interest from the community at the IGF, and so, you know, space might be, just from a purely logistical point of view, the space might be an issue, so I thought that would be one reason. But also, it brings in specifically the youth programs that were so well executed in Brazil and brings them forward. So that was the reason it struck me. And I'm heartened to see that it didn't strike just me as a good proposal, because it's number 5. In the outcome of the review. So essentially the premise is to engage internet and internet governance pioneers and the voices of the future, as you just said, Chair. Debating the issues and how to address them, the discussion will address key questions before the internet community and provide what I used quotes because I couldn't come up with anything better, old and new perspectives, particularly providing the youth perspective. So I really just put forward the workshop proposal, which lists out specific speakers that would fall in the pioneer side, as well as those that participated in the youth program. So it had specific speakers that were that they were engaging. It's outlined by the workshop proposal, and I suggested it could have adjustments as needed to pose provocative questions before these. Folks, generational differences about how the internet works and is used, the impact of youth participation in the internet ecosystem, preparing and engaging youth in internet governance themes, And then I added any additional issues that arise in the preparations and consultations that are required essentially by the main session guidelines. So the input from the community would augment the initial workshop proposal, which was already very good. I guess I would say I don't know if Flavio, who was kind enough to support my harebrained idea, might say a few words. But I also wanted to mention that Tiago and Marcel, who were the original workshop proposers, are here and would be available, I think, to answer any questions that the MAG members may have about the more substantive content and their initial proposal. So I'll leave it there, and Flavio, maybe you'd want to come in. Thank you.
Flavio, you have the floor.
Yeah. Thank you, Liesl, for the introduction, and thank you, Lynn. Just want to second the proposal. I think we have been talking a lot about youth engagement. There are many workshop proposals on youth engagement, but no other main session proposing this discussion. So I think it's important to have in the main sessions these discussions. If we organize well the schedule, this can be a kind of a conclusion of the many workshops that will be held maybe before discussing youth engagement, and then this can bring all those ideas into these main sessions. And I think it would be very nice to have this. I see other proposals in the main sessions, at least two or three, talking about sustainable development goals and internet economy and so on. So I think this is a different proposal. It is worthwhile to have it. Thank you.
thank you, Flavio. The queue is just more than doubled in the last minute or so, which maybe expresses some interest in this topic. We'll keep working our way through the queue until we stop for the lunch break, and then we'll come back and address it. I think there are 10 proposals in. There's sort of a proposal that we might put the best practice forums and connecting, enabling, and Xbillium into one forum, which means we have 9 proposals and 7 slots. I think some of the slots are a given based on the first MAG meeting, such as the NRI slot, clearly the combined BPF connecting, enabling, next billion. We had said both of those were. So we're down to a relatively small number of proposals that we need to evaluate, and I think we can come back and take the first pass at that immediately after lunch, and then try and determine where we go with the future development of those. But that's how I would propose to try and move that agenda item forward. Renata, you have the floor.
Yes, I would just comment quickly on the trade main session proposal. This proposal brings together a new civil society coalition on digital trade and is of interest to developing countries as well, since it deals also with intellectual property issues. And I would speak for my MAG colleague, Omar Ansari, who is also participating on this on the organization of this proposal. Unfortunately, we submitted our names very close to the deadline, so we didn't have time to amend properly the proposal. But this would be a proposal that we would have an interest on, especially since it refers also to the One Internet report released in June by the Global Commission on Internet Governance and multi-stakeholder model on Internet governance issues relating to encryption, censorship, transparency, and data. Thank you.
Thank you, Renata. UNESCO, you have the floor.
Thank you. I didn't finish just now, so I'd like to continue. Actually, first, I agree with what was just proposed about the main session on youth, which I think is really crucial. And secondly, from the proposal read by Lizo, I didn't hear any session really about human rights, which, given my experience from former IGF, that human rights session was always the best attended, most popular session among all the main sessions. I think we do need to keep this tradition and highlight free expression, privacy, and this crucial human rights related issues at the agenda of the main session, which tends to address the overarching issues about the internet governance. And also, I mean, I also want to stress the relations between the main session and the workshops, because I understand the function of main session serves several functions, either to compensate the insufficiently addressed issues of the workshops, like the youth, like maybe gender, maybe also some other issues, and also to address those cross-cutting issues. If we got so many workshops addressing the same issues, like Internet of Things, those emerging issues, why not we have a main session on that? And if so many workshops talking about human rights and free expression, why not we have to have those workshops to talk each other at the main session, because they are really talking about different issues. Now we need to have an overview about what is talking about, which will help us to produce more constructive outcomes. So, and the most maybe a main session about gender, if that's that's also an issue which has been discussed by so many workshops. And so this can help the work and IGF to produce more quality outcomes in the end.
Well, thank you. Very, very good comments. Zina, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I just want to point out that after reading that there were 70 submissions, including 22 from national and regional IGF regarding the policy paper to connect the next billion, I recommend to keep it as a main session and give it all the time and let everyone who has a say to add it in this session instead of merging it with others. I can see there are other session proposals that can be merged, but let us leave this one and give it all the importance it deserves. Thank you.
Thank you, Zina. Michael, you have the floor.
Thank you, Chairman. I wanted to start with a commercial. The Best Practices Forum Working Group is going to meet for lunch and try to finalize our mission statement. And we'll be in the cafeteria directly above the first conference room we met in on Tuesday. So just go there and take the escalator. And if there's other things going on, I'd be interested in knowing what else is happening over lunch. I just had a couple of quick points. One of them I think is uncontroversial, and that is I really wanted to support Liesl's idea of combining the Best Practices Forum with the next billion, because I think that works for several reasons. First, we do need space for the Best Practices Forum, but more importantly, three of the Best Practices Forum relate directly to the next billion initiative. I do think we have to ask ourselves if we want to have major initiatives like the next billion allocated a main session every year, because we had one last year. It doesn't mean we need to have one this year. And I think combining the two would actually get you a larger audience and could identify some synergies. More controversial, I think we have to do what Lynn said, which is we have to find at least two sessions that we don't think should be on this list. And I will offer up the trade session as something that I think is going to be very difficult to include as a main session. I think it's a very well-written proposal. All the proposals are very well-written, but and I agree with the viewpoints expressed in that proposal. The problem is that it's not going to be seen as a balanced debate about the trade issues. There are other proposals for sessions that will be on the other side of some of these issues, but they're not main sessions. So I think in order not to make it appear that we're picking one side of these different issues and promoting it as a main session, we might want to not include it. The other similar point could be made about the dynamic coalitions. I do agree we need to highlight the work they're doing, but in some cases the dynamic coalitions are organized around one political position and they're not going to even talk about any other viewpoints. So in order to not be seen as promoting a particular political agenda, and since we do have to find two that we're going to take off the table, I would suggest that. Thank you.
Thank you. I'll try and take two more comments before we break for lunch, but I'll also notice that there was a comment that said we also haven't addressed human rights, Internet of Things, and gender, which certainly are significant issues. So I'm not just trying to manage the two off the table. We're trying, of course, to get the main sessions we need for the forum, and we may be, in fact, pulling some other topics in. And I think we need to determine whether or not how the MAG actually feels about that, given there was a call and proposals should have come in. Jack, you have the floor, and Marcus, I'll give you the floor, and then we'll just pick up the queue after lunch.
Thanks, Chair. And I think maybe it might respond a little bit to the question around human rights and gender. The session around economic, social, and cultural rights is actually, in fact, building on the main sessions on human rights from previous years. It's really great to see human rights as being the biggest topic of interest as seen through the workshop proposals. But also, I think given this year's focus on the SDGs, it's also really good to build on the human rights conversation as well to be broader than civil and political rights, for example, so broader than freedom of expression, privacy. But I do note that maybe in the process of broadening this, we could be missing out on something. So perhaps it should be bigger and just say put it up front that it's human rights and economic, social, and cultural rights, so that it really does encompass both quite strongly. And one of the interests of looking at ESCR, not just in terms of the strong links to SDG, but looking at access as enabling the exercise of rights, is also to highlight things like gender issues, education, local content, multilingualism, access to information, health, and so on. So these are really, really good comments, and I think that will be taken into the shaping of the main session. And also, just to say that Ginger and I worked on this, but we really are open for another co-organizer, especially from another stakeholder group. So if anybody in MAG is interested, we really very much welcome this. And that the policy questions and the format and the shaping will also again be opened up for broader input by the IGF community too close to lunchtime. So we will open it up on the Google Docs, so there's definitely opportunities for input. And then to just build off Izumi's point on best practice forums as being quite useful to feed into other main sessions where it links. For example, connecting the next billion. There could also be BPs that maybe fits into the ESCR main session, so I think it'll be a good way to think through how this could be distributed into different spaces. The only thing, though, is just to think about, I think the only thing to consider is, do we want to have a main session on intersessional work specifically, looking at intersessional work as an important platform for achieving IGF outcomes? So that's the only sort of question to put out there, like, is there a purpose to this, and how might we want to do this, if so?
Well, that's a very good comment, Jack. And with that, Marcus, if you don't mind, I'll leave you as the first speaker after lunch. So I think I believe people have, although I haven't looked, do we have the reformatted spreadsheet sent out to the MAG yet, which has recategorized those that are in and then identified the 15 or so that are still open for consideration? Has that gone back out? If it hasn't gone back out, Chengatai is sending it out literally as we speak. So when we come back, and I'll talk to a few people and see what's appropriate, we'll either pick up this main session discussion and try and get it to a reasonable point. I think it's clear that we're going to have to continue some of the discussions online. And we will come back to the specific workshop proposals that were put out for review and try and close on that quickly. And then we have basically the other item was follow-up as needed based on status updates from open consultations and requests from a couple of the NRIs to give some brief updates on their activities during that session. And then we had some, you know, sort of housekeeping but important, most specifically scheduling the third face-to-face meeting. I think it's really important that we try and close in that today because a lot of people are going to be going away for holiday over the next few weeks, and I don't want to leave that open for another month or so because it just messes with schedules and the calendar gets full and we're apt to lose venue space as well. So Chengatai did send out a proposal last night. If we could look at that when we come back. And those that are participating online, if you have any specific comments to that and aren't going to be with us this afternoon, please make sure that either Anya or Chengatai have it so that we can take that into account as well. And with that, I thank everybody again this morning. Thank the interpreters as well. And please, if we could start back really promptly at 3, that would be really helpful. Thank you.